Bishop, you're actually a relative, aren't you, of the New Saints?
Yes, I'm connected in some sort of way, yes. I would be probably through Mary McKillop's grandfather's generation. My ancestor would have been a brother of her grandfather, like.
Right, and
the McKillop side.
Was she legendary?
Quite close, because she did. Pardon?
Was she legendary in your family?
No, to be honest, we didn't know that much about her until, you know, in the last 20 years, when we heard that they were wanting to canonise this lady in Australia, who was connected to many of the people in Mojave and the near Fort William, that area, you know. So we began to find out about her then, and people, you know, there were more people coming and going and telling us about her story and her life. That. And then we discovered too that she had actually visited Scotland in the 1870s, and she had visited many places in our area. So that was, so it was nice to know that she had come back to Scotland to find her roots there, and she spoke very warmly of her time in Scotland.
And how did you find out you were related to her?
Oh, well, I think there's a lot of interest nowadays in relationships, and people make family trees, and in the Highlands, there's a local interest, and then there's many people who have gone abroad, and many come back and ask about their relationships, and, you know, it's stirred up more of an interest in our connections across the world. So, it's quite good that we have these connections in Canada. I mean, Peter Square at the moment, and there's people that are from Canada and Australia and New Zealand and different places who have some connection to Mary McKillop.
And now, what is it, what's most important about her, or most significant about her?
I think for us, you know, the being made a saint is a very important event in the church's life. And it's a sort of recognition that she was an extraordinary lady, and she did great work in her time with the religious sisters that taught in the schools that she founded, and the other good works they did. But I think too, there's been a devotion to her, both in Australia, which is very, very alive, and many people visit her tomb and pray at her tomb, and in our own country too, the people have got to know of her. You find people that have prayed to and with her and ask her help for people that are ill or suffering in different ways. So there have been people that feel that their prayers to Mary McKillop have been answered in some way, and they feel very attached and close to her. So I think that's sort of a sign of the saintliness in the church, that the person's memory is kept alive. And the devotion and prayers to her as a saint are a very real and important thing for a number of people.
And what are you doing to mark the occasion in Rome?
Well, we're attending the canonisation on Sunday, and we're going to attend the other events. There's a vigil tomorrow afternoon, and then on Sunday itself, the Mass of Canonisation. And then on Monday, there's the Mass of Thanksgiving at St. Paul's Basilica, and all the people from Australia and elsewhere that have come for that event. So that'll really be the event which brings together all the people who are in Rome who have come from Mary McKillop specifically, because there are other people being canonised as well on Sunday. There'll be people from other parts of the world, which is lovely as well that we're sharing the occasion with people from different countries.
And how many have gone with you from Scotland?
Well, I think there's about 140 altogether in our group. Now, some are from England, and some have joined us from. I met a couple of people last night in the United States who are Scots that live there, and they've come over especially for this. So, but our particular group is about 140, which is very good, really.
Where are you staying in Rome?
Well, we're staying in the La Lancelot Hotel, and some half the group are there, and some are in another hotel.
And what kind of stories are you hearing from members of the group?
Like stories?
Yes.
Well, I mean, we're just settling into Rome at the moment, and we're finding we had a mass though on Sunday in Roy Bridge, in the old cemetery there, and there was a group of Australians who had come to Scotland before coming to Rome, and we joined with them, and many of the local people that were travelling to Rome were at the mass on Sunday, and it was a lovely occasion to kind of prepare for coming, and people felt very emotional about the links between us and the people in Australia, and you know, the Mary MacKillop's presence with us in that sense, uniting us and sort of us going together for our canonisation. So we feel quite emotional and sort of yes. proud too that somebody with their roots in the Highlands of Scotland being canonised.
We often hear about the advance of secularisation in the West and in Britain, but yet the Pope's visit was a great success, almost beyond everyone's hopes and expectations, and now we have this canonisation. Do you think faith is dying out, or do you think, is this a sign of the opposite's happening?
I think it's a sign. I think, you know, this, I was speaking to people last night, and in our group, they say, "Oh, this is the being coming to Rome, the sense of the faith. This is the faith of our fathers." And today we celebrated Mass in the Basilica of San Clemente, and it went back to the 4th century. And there's a great sense, I think, of the continuity of faith. And I think in a lot of ways, when the younger folk that come here to Rome, especially, are quite touched by that. And you know, and I think for us in the Highlands too. That this event has kind of awakened that sense of our, you know, the heritage that we have, and there's maybe a wee bit of a revival in the sense of faith and of interest in the ways of faith, and I think the saints like Mary MacKillop are a kind of inspiration for us, you know, to find a way of living which is influenced by the Christian faith, and where people really sacrifice something for others and for the faith in Christ.
And what do you say to people who argue that it's just superstition?
Well, I think there's people who might think that, but I think one of our things in the Catholic Church is the universal sort of nature of the Church and that sort of recognising the holiness of the people that have lived in the Church. And I think it's very nice that we do sort of pick out people from time to time and say, well, these people live lovely lives and uplifting lives and they're witnesses to Christ. And we sense the communion between those who have gone before us and those who are here on earth. And that's the sense of our praying with